Hello everyone, today we are going to read about the types of RNA polymerases in both eukaryotic and prokaryotic organisms. So RNA polymerase are required for the transcription. So after the knowing concept of the RNA polymerase, I'll proceed further in the concept of the transcription. So before starting transcription, you should really know the types of RNA polymerases. So RNA polymerase, the RNA polymerase are present both in eukaryotes and prokaryotes. So there are eukaryotic RNA polymerases and there are prokaryotic RNA polymerases. In eukaryotic RNA polymerases, there are RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2, RNA polymerase 3. So RNA polymerase 1 makes the ribosomal RNA. RNA polymerase 1 makes the ribosomal RNA. It is the most common type of RNA polymerase. It is present only in the nucleolus. The RNA polymerase 2 makes the mRNA, microsomal RNA and small nuclear RNA. So the RNA polymerase 2 makes the mRNA, microsomal RNA and small nuclear RNA. There is one important concept you should know, that the alpha amanitin found in Amanita phalloids, which is also known as the death cap mushroom, inhibits RNA polymerase 2. Alpha amanitin is RNA polymerase 2 is inhibited by the alpha amanitin 2, which is found in the Amanita phalloids, which is also known as the death cap mushroom. This alpha amanitin inhibits the RNA polymerase 2. It causes severe hepatotoxicity if ingested. So it causes hepatotoxicity if ingested. So now the RNA polymerase 3 makes 5S RNA and the tRNA, the transfer RNA. So this is the RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2 and RNA polymerase 3 found in the eukaryotic organisms. So let us discuss about the prokaryotic RNA polymerases. There is only one RNA polymerase that makes all three kinds of RNA. There is only one types of RNA polymerase that makes all three kinds of RNA. That is alpha to beta and beta prime. This structure here is the RNA polymerase of the prokaryotic organism. So now let us discuss the structure of the prokaryotic. Let us discuss the prokaryotic RNA polymerase. So the RNA polymerase of the prokaryotic organism is the complex holoenzyme. The core enzyme consists of the alpha to beta and beta prime. This is the core enzyme. And this is the sigma factor. Along with the combination of this core enzyme and sigma factor, it becomes holoenzyme. It becomes the holoenzyme. The sigma factor, the protein called sigma factor, is required for the initiation of the transcription at the promoter. The sigma factor is released immediately the sigma factor is released immediately after the initiation of the transcription. The termination of transcription sometimes required a protein called rho factor. So the sigma factor is required for the initiation of the transcription. So required to initiate the promoter. Now there is one drug called actinomycin D. The actinomycin D inhibits the RNA polymerase of the both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Whereas there is one drug called rifampin. The rifampin inhibits the RNA polymerase of prokaryotes only. So this is the concept of the RNA polymerase in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Thank you.